So what we did is we created for her what I call, and you can find one plug that I'm done for tonight. We go into real in-depth in my book on how to create this personal horror profile. We spent a lot of time in the book on this. Because here's the thing. I have two kids. My daughter would walk in the door, not pass go, not pass the kitchen, not take her coat off, sit down, and get her homework done. At 3:21. Okay? That was Maddie Josel. Eli Josel, you couldn't even talk to when you picked him up in the car. Because this is what he was like. I used to say this at an IEP meeting. I want everybody in the room to suck your stomach in. Go ahead. Suck your stomach in. Now hold that for 8 hours. That is my son. So when he walked into my car at the end of the day, do you think he needed to sit down and do homework? No, he needed to breathe. He just needed to be. So his personal homework profile is very different than hers. He needed to wait and refuel. He liked to do homework where we were in the house. We'll talk about that. He liked music. I would walk in my house and the book of Mormon would be blasting. Okay, I the fear did. I knew it was home. Now it's more the Beatles or whatever it is. But my daughter, absolute quiet. You need to tap into your child's best practices. And you could be doing this at 7 or 17 and figure out what makes them tick. Do they need music? Do they need quiet? Do they need to be near people? Because that tumult, somebody might not, you know, that activity might help them to activate. Or do they need to be apart because too much of that doesn't, do they need to go outside and be very tactile? I have a family where the mom at night takes, what is it, sidewalk chalk, and the daughter does her math in sidewalk chalk. Why not? It's great. Or I have another student that jumped on the trampoline while they were being tested with flashcards. Okay? There's no rules. So, what did I do for, I set up some homework games. And these are amazing for you guys to do at home. You can start this tomorrow.